Are you ready for some Procreate fun? Well, let's jump in! Hi, and welcome to this YouTube series. My name is Brenda Bakker and I'm from the Netherlands. Today I'm going to create this letter O, written in gold foil, floating upon the paper with a little bit of shadow underneath. The letter O is inspired by the book Alphabet Brush Lettering for Everybody by the Dutch Carla Kamphuis. And this was a real challenge for me also, which you will see in the video. But luckily we have the two-finger undo tip, so we can practice and manage the letters just until we like it. So let's get started. Because this is a difficult one, I'm going to roughly sketch it a couple of times at front, so I have the muscle memory in my hand. So let's try for this one. I think it's going to be something like this. Let's do it again. Just keep it in mind. I want it to be a crossover here and not here. So let's do it again. Well, I have to practice also. I think the crossover would be fine, but this one isn't nice. So let's make this another practice, just as long as I'm happy with it. Yeah, I think this curl could be a little bit longer. Let's do this another time, perhaps one more time. Yes. I think this one will be a lovely one, so let's try this one. And for that, I'm going to lower the opacity. So it's still visible, but not too much. Going to create a new layer on top and go to my messy brush pen, or you can choose any brush pen you would like. And remember, I want this stroke to be thick and this upward stroke thin, but also this downward stroke will be thin. So the only thing that's really thick is this downstroke, and maybe here at the beginning and somewhat at the end. Well, let's try. I have to make it a quick one because I want to have it a smooth line. So I will try and just, well, let's get started. So push, lift. Push, lift, 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 push. That will be something, but I don't like to cross over here. I want it to be approximately here. So let's do this again. Like so. Push, lift, push, lift, 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 push, push. Not also how I want it. So let's do this again. I'm very hard for myself, but now you see I have to practice myself too. Maybe I won't talk and just do. Maybe that's better because then I don't have to think so much. I think the shape is already getting better, but I want this more wide. Let's keep this one. And then I can have some more and, well, choose the best one. Almost. I think I do like this one. I don't like this part, but I think I will follow and, well, make some adjustments to this. And always erase with the same brush. I think I take this one. Yes, so let's keep this one. We could get rid of all of these. And now what are we going to do with this one? Well, let me see. And now I've downloaded a gold foil photo from Unsplash and I've saved it to my photos. So I'm going to choose the wrench tool, insert a photo, go to my gallery, add in this picture. And for that one, I'm going, well, it's also on top of it. So now I'm going to create a clipping mask out of it. So it clips it only to the pixels one below. So let's see what it does. It gives a clipping mask. And now the foil is only on the pixels below. You can see this little arrow here that's pointing to the layer underneath. It doesn't do anything elsewhere, only on the pixels on the layer underneath. So now let's duplicate this one. So now I take the one underneath and I can make that a shadow. So just by pulling it a little bit to this side, well, maybe make it a floating one. So it's more elegant. And then let's choose Gaussian blur, choose layer. And so now it's a little bit of shadow on the wall behind it. And let's change the opacity a bit. Some more. Yes, I like that. And because I did it on a watercolor paper, maybe I'm going to brighten my foil. No, because it's black underneath. Well, I can change that by changing the color into white. So select this one and fill layer. Now it's white underneath. Let me see if it works then. Yes, I can do that, but my foil is not as bright then, so maybe I'll keep it on 80%. So now you've got a lovely floating letter O in gold foil with a shadow underneath. So I hope you like this small tutorial. You see, I also have to practice on my strokes, my upwards and my downstrokes, before I've got the right shape of the letter. Well, this was a difficult one, so thank you, Carla, for this challenge. Well, I hope you like it. See you in the next one. Thank you for watching this episode until the very end. If you like this video and think I've earned it, please give this video a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't already. More detailed tutorials can be found on Skillshare. These and all other links can be found in the description below. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!